Well, glad you went, because the Supreme Court struck down New York's law that you need a good and substantial reason or a reason to want to conceal carry. So if that happens, eventually it's going to come down to Maryland, because, you know, Maryland is you need a good and substantial reason, but there's no clear definition of good and substantial reason.
Plus, Baltimore is the only city I know in the United States, and people can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think Baltimore is the only city that has a gun registry. So, you know, if you've been, you know, like, flagged for any sort of gun crimes in the past, you're putting on this...
Oh, this list. I mean, Maryland has... I'm pretty sure other ones do that. I don't know for sure.
Maybe now, but as far as I know, Baltimore was the only one that had a gun offender registry. Yeah. It's like, you on a gun offender registry? What the fuck was you doing? He said, no, not that gun. The other type of gun.
But it's going to be interesting, because it's going to happen in Maryland. And like I said, Maryland doesn't have a clear definition of a good substantial reason. It doesn't clearly define what's a good and substantial reason to want to get a concealed carry permit. Outside of, well, unless you're a business owner, you carry a lot of cash, or you have an assumed risk status. Other than that, it's kind of up to the Maryland State Police to decide if they want you. Pretty much is the state. It's just the state police saying, "Do I feel like I want to let you?"
Well, the state police doesn't decide it. You mean the state legislature?
No, I'm talking about who gets a gun. The state legislature doesn't look at the reviewed applications.
No, I'm saying, but they will put into law if Maryland did have a similar law on the books, then it could probably be affected by the repeal of the one in New York.
Right. They have one. They do have a similar law.
Yeah, so they already said that it's going to affect states nationwide, because, you know, when you strike down one law in one place, on the federal level, it's going to have ripple effects
throughout the state. No, that's what I'm saying.
Throughout the country, yeah.
What I'm saying is, when applications here in the state of Maryland, when you put in for a concealed carry, basically, it's just the state police, because they're the ones who decide who gets it.
Okay.
Are just basically looking at the application and saying, do I feel like I want to give this person one or not? Basically, that's all it is, unless you have a business and can prove that you carry a large sum of cash, or you have an assumed risk status. It has loosened up now to where if you're a federal employee with any type of a DOD employee, you can get it because you kind of have an assumed risk status. So it's loosened up a bit.
So Kingpin can't afford. He said, look, man, I'm moving all this weight every day. Look, I'm trying. Look, I need to fly in this fentanyl from Mexico. Look, I got stacks of papers. I need this concealed carry stuff.
No, but, I don't think everybody needs a concealed carry. However, I will say this. When people make the argument, well, having a concealed carry isn't going to make us safer, I'm like, well, y'all not doing nothing to curb the violence in Baltimore anyway.
Well, that is true. I mean, I think for certain individuals that actually do need it, then, yeah, I'm sure it would be beneficial. But, yeah, statistically, no, it's not really.
It's not going to make it. And I do agree. I don't think it's going to make anybody safer. However, I will say this.
But there is a deterrent effect.
No, that's what I'm saying. There is a deterrent, because most shooters in Baltimore, most of those people walking around with firearms don't have a permit.
Yeah, they're burners.
Right. And it's the law-abiding citizens who tend to end up being the victims getting caught up, because most criminals, I know you ain't got no gun. But if there is a chance, he could be packing. I don't know if I'm going to do it. I mean, it's a deterrent. Like I said, there's no clear way of doing that, but if I know you got a sword and I got a sword.
Yeah, when people walked around with an open sword on their hilt.
It kind of deterred a lot of shit. I mean,
like, you're not going to just rob this dude and he's walking around with his...
with a sword. Even if you got a sword, you're going to think twice about it.
Yeah, because then it comes to who got the better skills.
Exactly.
And the role of chance. So,
like I said, I'm all for it. I don't mind. I think... I'm cool with people having carry permits. Like I said, excuse me, for me though, I think there should be a background check, there should be a psych evaluation, it should be all those things.
Yeah, as long as background checks and all that sort of stuff, I don't mind, because the thing is, if someone is applying for concealed carry, then they're probably more of a responsible gun owner than the individual ratchet on the street, like some of the people I used to work with. I'm not going to say their names.
And I agree. And then even when people say, well, what about the good, you know, everybody's going to try to be a hero. I'm like, no, they're not.
No, they're not. And I'll tell you, I'm not, because every time a black guy tries to play hero, he gets shot.
And so
if cop I see... be like, oh, he got gun.
So I'm not jumping in to be no cap.
You just help someone and then they shoot you.
Yeah, I'm not jumping in. I ain't trying to save nobody. Nope. I'm trying to save me.
Now, if it's like some sort of like racist attack or something like that, I might jump in for that. But I'm not jumping into no gunfight or anything like that. I'm sorry. Like,
and nobody will dispatch you to. And the thing is, when people make these arguments against concealed carries, I'm like, first of all, most people haven't been in a firefight, so they're not getting a concealed carry to go be a hero. Because most people have not been in a fight.
And I can tell you from people in war, even people in war don't just buck like that. Like, when people are in a gunfight and actual combat, most people duck and hide and just, try to shoot. Like, they'll, do some suppression fire or whatever back at the enemies. But no one's trying to get shot. Like, everyone's ducking and dodging, even in real combat. So, and these are trained people. So what is the average person gonna do? Like,
and that's my point. Like, it's just weird. It's weird. And like I said, concealed carries. And it's funny because when I see women argue against, I'm like, well, you complain about so much violence against you, wouldn't it make sense for you to have a firearm on you? Since all men are potential,
coming for your booty, matey.
Wouldn't it make sense for you to carry like a little firearm in your purse to protect yourself against all those mean old men?
I'll make my wife carry something. So
I'm just saying, it would benefit women. You know, the patriarchy is trying to give you the means to protect yourself from the patriarchy.
It's sort of like the rant feminists and liberals rant against the patriarchy. It's sort of like people's rant against capitalism, particularly like the market economy, not capitalism in general, but maybe like the market economy. Like, for all the problems that the market creates, the market can also create solutions to those problems. The best way to solve a market induced problem is a market solution. And the patriarchy does the same thing. For all the problems supposedly that the patriarchy causes, the patriarchy also offers solutions to. Like, the patriarchy is the one that
gave women alimony. The patriarchy.
Any sort of society, any sort of government structure, like, all of them had their traitors. Which ones are you willing to live with and which ones you aren't? So
I don't know. As far as I'm concerned, I don't listen to women when they complain about the patriarchy, particularly white women. Because for all the bad things that for all the evil the patriarchy is, they're the main beneficiaries of it. No other, the ability to just call the police and say a black man is doing something to me, and the police will automatically assume you're in danger. Like,
they would teleport there like they're Goku.
Right. Like, it's a transmission.
They're like, 911, a black man. What? Where is he?
Right, and for all the woes of the patriarchy, white women have benefited from it the most. Yeah, you have some aspects of it that suck, but literally the entire country is built on a cheat code for you to win, and you still fail. And not just white people in general.
Yeah, and like I said, that's why I brought up the Roe versus Wade thing, because that was brought up in the Black Manosphere the last couple of days. The whole Roe versus Wade case was originally formed on a white woman lying, saying a black man raped her in the state of Texas, just because that was the only way that she could get an abortion. And then later, you know, admitted that she frankly did lie, because, you know, it wasn't convenient for her wanted to have the pregnancy. So she ended up being forced to still have the pregnancy. Then she later gave the baby away for adoption. So bring us back to the gun law repeal. The concealed carry repeal in Texas. So some people are bringing up a good case.
In New York.
New York. I'm sorry. So people are making a good case that it seems kind of inconsistent where the Supreme Court's deciding where something is states' rights and something isn't states' rights. So on the one hand, you know, they're saying the states don't have the right to determine who can
conceal carry.
conceal carry, or, you know, basically decide their gun.
States can't decide their own gun laws, but states can decide who gets an abortion.
Exactly.
And then, you know, then you have feminists again making out, well, guns are more important than our lives. And I'm like, and I'm tired of hearing, like, I get it, women do die in pregnancy, and it is messed up, and it does happen, and it's not right. You know, I get it. But I guess what I'm tired of hearing is trying to make this woe is me thing, where it's like, you can, there are literally, like, steps and things put in place to prevent you from getting pregnant.
Step one, don't have sex.
Step two,
use a condom.
Step three, swallow. Step four, anal. Step five,
get all the... Your pullout game gotta be tight, son.
Step six, all the contraceptions out there. Now, I get, and I do get it, you know, when women say, well, I don't want to take all these hormones. I get it. I get it. But condoms are not going anywhere,
and they are
cheap.
And here's another inconsistency they forget is that they always talk about, well, why don't men take birth control pills? Look, there's actually been a male birth control pill since the late 70s, early 80s, but most men won't take it. And
then they'll say, well,
and the thing is, it actually behooves the woman to use the contraceptives, because it's their body that's going to go through the pregnancy. So
it's your body. Protect your body.
Yeah, it has, it's more.
If you want better options to protect your body, I agree. Look, I really think there should be birth control should be better tailored for women. I do agree with that. But at the end of the day, it's your body. If you're gonna leave,
do you really want to trust the guy to say he took that pill? Oh yeah, baby, I took that pill.
We don't even trust you to take your pills.
Shoot, guys are even like sneakily pulling off the condom. So no, you gonna trust them with the pill?
You know what? And I do hear that, but the reason I don't use that talking point, because most women,
I don't know how common that is, but it does.
It happened, but to let them tell it happens all the time. But when we say, well,
so they can't tell the difference. They can tell the difference. They just didn't care,
right? Or they'll tell you when
they know the difference between latex
and raw
dog.
But when you tell women, you know what, women, you know, steal condoms to impregnate themselves. No, they don't, but. It okay. That don't happen.
That's straight.
But that's just my point. Like it's just a whole bunch of what's, I can't even think of the word I want to use right now.
Bullshit.
That's an easier way. So I was gonna try to use something more sophisticated, but yeah, it's a bunch of bullshit. Like, it's your body. Like, I have had them tell me don't use a condom. Bitch, fuck you. I'm using a condom. Like, no. Like, it's your body. You should take whatever measures are needed to protect your body.
Sometimes I listened, sometimes I didn't. Well, one chick, she was a stripper. I definitely wrapped it up. If I could have, I would have put on 3 condoms. Like, she was like, no. She was like, condoms aren't always effective either. I'm like, okay, I'm keeping this bad boy on.
But that's my point.
Talking about she slept with the dude from WWE. Who was the guy that used to come on the stage with all the whores? He was like a pimp. What was his name? Oh man, he was cool as hell. No. The dude, like at the end of the fight, he would bring up all his hoes on the stage and they'd be dancing.
I don't know.
Oh, they might have been before your era, but that was the joint. So that was like, she's like with that dude, and she was in the military. For people who don't know, military women. That's all I'm gonna say. That's all I'm gonna say. But yeah, so I was like, yeah, I'm wrapping that up. Now, on the other hand, someone I knew when I was in college, you know, she was of a different persuasion, and it was first time, you know, getting down with the curry. So, oh well. But,
I'll roll these dice.
Shake them up, shake them up, shake them up, shake them. But all right, it's getting hot, so I'm about to go. But yeah, so we have the concealed carry law repealed in the state of New York. And we got the Roe versus Wade decision overturned. So it's been a busy week for the Supreme Court. We'll see what else happens in the future. And, you know, some people in the black manosphere are saying, should we start supporting Clarence Thomas now?
No.
No. No, I don't think so.
Like, in his...
Shout out to Dennis Sperling. I love his content, but no. Not at all. He... I still think he should probably be kicked out of the Supreme Court for his bullshit with he and his dumbass wife.
Nah. Like, again, we... Just because he was a victim of racial epitaphs, so, doesn't mean he's, like, down for the cause.
Neither, every black person was called the N-word at some point in their time.
Right. So, who cares? But, nah.
He's a big boy. He can take it.
Pretty much.
He's no Thurgood Marshall. All right, guys. I'm signing out.